morning, boys and girls. I'm very happy to be sharing the gospel with you today. Today is the 26th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Ordinary Time is a time for us to grow in our knowledge and love for Jesus. In today's gospel, Jesus observed how people were behaving. He noticed that people were talking a lot about following God's rules and doing what God asked of them. But he also noticed that people who talked about following God's rules didn't always behave the way they should. They were not making loving choices. Let's listen now to the story Jesus told the people about two sons. Please stand and let's sing the Alleluia. Halle, 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 Alleluia. Halle, 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 Alleluia. Halle, 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 Alleluia. Hallelujah, hallelujah. My sheep listen to my voice, says the Lord. I know them and they follow me. Halle, 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 hallelujah. Halle, 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 hallelujah. Halle, 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 hallelujah. Halle, a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, I will tell you a story about a man who had two sons. Then you can tell me what you think. The father went to the older son and said, go to work in the vineyard today. His son told him that he would not do it, but later he changed his mind and went. The man then told his younger son to go work in the vineyard. The boy said he would, but he didn't go. Which one of the sons obeyed the father? The older one, the chief priests and leaders answered. Then Jesus told them, you can be sure that tax collectors and bad women will get into the kingdom of God before you ever will. When John the Baptist showed you how to do right, you would not believe him. But these evil people did believe, and even when you saw what they did, you still would not change your minds and believe. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Boys and girls, I have some questions for you to ponder. Let's think for a moment about today's gospel. When the father in the story asked the first son to do some work in his vineyard, what did his son say? Did you say that I will not do it? Great, that is correct. Then what happened? The son thought about his responsibility and his respect for his father, so he went and did what his father asked. When the father asked his second son to work in the vineyard, what did he say? Did you say yes? Great, that is also correct. But then what happened? The son said the right thing because he respected his father, but he didn't do what his father asked him to do. Then Jesus asked the people, which one of the sons obeyed his father? Was it the first son or the second son? Do you think Jesus was saying that people who say the right words and look like they know how to do what God asked them aren't always the ones who do the right things? Yes, I think that that was what he was saying. In fact, some people who were labeled as sinners, like tax collectors back in Jesus' time, were humble enough to recognize their sins and do the right thing. They asked God to forgive their sinful behaviors so that they could become members of God's kingdom. They decided to make loving choices and to follow Jesus. Boys and girls, what can we learn from this parable? Jesus teaches us that it is not right for us to judge other people by what they say or do. We cannot look into their hearts. Only God can do that. The only one person we can judge is ourselves. We need to be humble, recognize our sins, ask for God's forgiveness, and make a change in the way we live our lives and follow Jesus. Let's pause for a moment and think of a way we can follow Jesus this week by making good choices. Asking Jesus to forgive us if we don't, and try hard to make loving choices every day next week. Let's bow our heads, close with the words to a song from the musical called Godspell. Day by day, O dear Lord, three things I pray: to see thee more clearly, to love thee more dearly, and follow thee more nearly, day by day. Goodbye, boys and girls. Have a wonderful Sunday.